Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with Zeyek's Starship. Zeyek being this guy, the chronicler, storyteller character that I created for the Bionicle world years ago and since ported over to the Hero Factory universe. This is his ship, his personal ship. Has the ability to travel great distances. It's not just a short distance little thing. I never came up with a backstory for this ship. It's kind of like a thing that's a little bit of a mystery, even to me, even though I made the mock. Whether he is able to travel between different universes with this ship, I do not know. I don't know if it has technology that's that advanced, or if he just travels to a place where there are portals or some other device, whether he's able to travel through time with this thing, I don't know. I know that he has existed or has chronicled things in many different time periods by actually going there. I know he's been alive for quite a long time, but he has told stories of things that should have been way before he was created. It's just a mock that I made, basically starting from the seat. Is how I made it. I started from making this just to fit the figure and built from there. I knew that I wanted to have some sort of cage sort of thing. And I knew that I kind of wanted to have two separate sections to the side of it to get that kind of look, but really didn't have any major plan going into this thing. And I think I was a little bit limited on parts by this time. By the time I made this, I had purchased a lot of the Bionicle sets, used sets from eBay when the popularity of Bionicle was already going way, way down, long before they discontinued the series. So I did have a lot of sets, but I just didn't have the kind of variety of parts that I do today. I also didn't really know how to use the parts all that well. So a lot of this was learning experience. You can see there's a little bit of flexibility down the center. It doesn't have a lot of structure fore to aft to kind of tie things together. But it's mostly for display. The whole idea of the stacked engines having one above the other was, looks like with the wide angle lens, it's looking a little bit bent, but that was just because I knew that I wanted to have multiple and either one huge engine or multiple engines. And when I looked at the parts that I had, I realized that I was going to have to stack them one way or another. And doing it this way allowed them to stay a little bit more compact, left a little bit of room between the center section of the ship and the side pods, left that a little bit open, which was important to me just for the look. And it worked out, and I got a little bit of asymmetry in there, going from one side to the other. So that's always a good thing. Well, not always a good thing, but often a good thing. Symmetry is easy to do. Asymmetry is not easy to do well. You have to really put some thought into it. He does have the ability to shoot with this thing. Got a couple of Zamor sphere launchers. He actually has another pair in here that aren't used. That's part of just the structure of the thing, but these down here actually do work and actually can shoot effectively. Probably there's a way to get this to work out too, because this can actually be rotated open. Maybe I could consider that to be four launchers. I don't know. It wasn't intended to be, though. That's why I didn't even put a sphere into there. I just kept this closed down. So he actually shoots. I kind of like these shapes, a little bit of hook kind of thing, add a little bit of evil kind of touch to it, as well as the front. I really liked how the front turned out. These big pods down the sides are really just to fit his feet in there. He's got a couple of little pegs where he can put his feet, and he's got some sensors, various antennae and sensors up towards the front, and these blades just really help to add to that evil feel or dark kind of feel, even though Zeyek himself is not particularly a bad character. We really don't know if he's good or bad. We don't know about his past, but I didn't want him to look too good, and I didn't want his stuff to look too good either, because that would kind of mess with his mystique. So I'll go ahead and put Zeyek in here so you can see how he sits in the thing, since it was really built around him to begin with. Got an attachment point right here with just, oh, that's not actually the way it's supposed to come off. Dope. It's supposed to come off here. There we go. One single pin just kind of opens that up, gives enough room. I'll go ahead and put him in. And that's basically it there. He fits in really well. Like I said, there are a couple of pegs in here. I can actually open this up. There was one way, at least. It's been a lot of years since I messed with this thing. It's just been on display for a couple of years. I believe, yeah, this would open up just to make sure that his feet can get on these two little pegs. He has kind of a heel on his feet, on each of his feet, and it really, really locks in. So this is only going to go up a little bit. It's pretty well situated in there. You know, there's no chance of him falling out. So just close that down in there. And he does hold on to controls on either side. I'll give you a closer look at that. His hand actually gets, you know, holds on pretty well, has good angle on that. And on the other side, yeah, you can see it from the front, just how both hands attach like so. And he can look forward pretty well. He's got his headrest is at a pretty good angle. It kind of goes behind his neck a little bit there. And yeah, that's it. Zeyek and his Starship. Or should I say, Zeyek's Starship and him. If you haven't seen stuff about Zeyek before, I've got a separate video where I just show the figure. And going way, way back, if you go to JANGBRiCKS.com, you can see all the old stuff, which used to be published on a separate domain that was all just in his voice as a storyteller. You can see stuff that I did for the Bionicle universe, additional kind of backstory for things, explaining the official stories in slightly darker ways without changing history, just kind of adding to it and clarifying things. I also have stories that I've done using him in the Hero Factory universe, so check some of that stuff out if you're interested, if you haven't seen it before. Otherwise, thank you again for watching this video, and stay tuned for more to come. I'm gonna go build some more stuff. Bye for now.